Did you watch disaster movies when you were a child? Were you afraid that our planet might collide with another space object? At different times, we've heard or seen many different stories about the fall of meteorites. Yes, in fact, the Earth does collide with different small bodies every day. But the likelihood is extremely small that we'll meet something much larger on our journey through space. Although, there are objects in our solar system that, unlike us, have not been able to avoid such a fate. In this case, Callisto, the moon of Jupiter, became the lucky one, if you want to call it that. It seems like most of the objects in our planetary system have crashed into it. It's also in second place as the space body with the highest number of craters on its surface. Only Phobos, a moon of Saturn, has more.
Hello. The first in outer space.
Let's go a little deeper into history. Callisto was discovered, along with three other moons, by famous Italian scientist Galileo Galilei in the 17th century. The moon was named after Callisto, an ancient Greek nymph, daughter of the Arcadian king Lycaon. In translation, the name means the most beautiful. At the time of its discovery, Callisto was listed in all documents as one of the four moons of Jupiter. In those days, it could only be seen remotely through a telescope. A significant contribution to the study of the object was made by the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 research devices, which we've already discussed with you in previous episodes. They were zipping through space near the great giant planet Jupiter. As a result, we received wonderful images of Callisto and some information regarding its characteristics. From 1994 to 2003, the Galileo device, which was designed specifically to study Jupiter, circled Callisto several times. In 2000, a probe called Cassini, which was sent to Saturn to study it, recorded the infrared spectrum of Jupiter's moon, which had a high resolution. In 2007, we also got more pictures of Callisto. A year ago, the European Space Agency and NASA jointly launched a project to explore Jupiter's moons and also its magnetosphere. Four developments for space exploration took part in it. Callisto is considered one of the largest moons in our planetary system. Only the moons Ganymede and Titan are larger. Its radius is more than 2,000 kilometers, and its diameter is almost the same as that of Mercury. Like our moon, it always moves in an orbit and is tidally locked to its planet, always showing only one side. The density of Callisto is several times less than the density of our planet, as it actually contains a roughly equal amount of ice and stones. The moon's ice layer is about 200 kilometers thick. It's assumed that under this layer, there's a salty ocean with a depth of about 10 kilometers. It can exist in a liquid state, that is, not freeze, only if there's a certain amount of ammonia in its composition. Otherwise, the top layer of ice would be about 300 kilometers thick. In front of a crater, the inner side of the object doesn't show any damage. This fact may indicate that water blocks impact shockwaves. The next layer is the mantle, which includes particles of ice and various rocks. The shorter the distance to the center, the greater is the density of this mixture. Why does Callisto stand out from other moons? It doesn't have a core that can be easily identified as separate from other layers. It's assumed that it contains silicates, which means that its diameter would not be more than about 600 kilometers. If there is a layer of water on this moon of Jupiter, we can assume that life could possibly arise there. But that said, conditions are not the most suitable. Although Callisto's upper layer is mostly ice, its color is brownish. This is due to the fact that cosmic dust and other debris accumulate on its surface. If you carefully study the images of Callisto, you'll see that some areas appear brighter. This is due to the fact that in certain places, dust doesn't accumulate in great quantities. During study of the moon, a huge number of craters were observed. There are so many of them that as their number grows, they overlap each other. This fact lets us understand that Callisto is quite old, about 4 billion years old. Where do you think all these craters came from? You might think it logical to assume they're from volcanoes, but scientists found that there was no pronounced volcanic activity on Callisto. This means that these are all traces of collisions with other space objects. Thus, the relief map of Callisto is quite fascinating. It contains both multi-ring formations and systems of craters. One of the largest craters is called Asgard, whose diameter exceeds 1,500 kilometers, and its age is over 3 billion years. This name, which some of you might recognize, was also taken from mythology. This was the name of the residence of the Scandinavian gods. You know, where Thor lives. On Callisto, Asgard can be recognized by its brightness and the circles around it. There are two more craters within the crater itself. Do is located in the central part, and Utgar in the north, and it has a width of approximately 600 kilometers. Near Asgard, there are also other impact craters, with their main features being that they also glow quite brightly. Another huge crater, Valhalla, is the largest of the impact craters in the planetary system and is located near the equator. If we count the formations in the form of the circles around it, then its diameter reaches over 3,800 kilometers. Notably, Valhalla was recorded by one of the Voyagers at the beginning of its mission. Researchers conditionally divide this crater into three parts. An inner one with a diameter of 360 kilometers and a fairly smooth surface, as well as zones of rocks and also areas of depressions. It's worth mentioning another of the largest impact craters on Callisto, Heimdall. Its diameter reaches 210 kilometers, and it's located close to the South Pole. It was first recorded by Voyager 1, and then Galileo provided pictures of the crater. The name Heimdall may ring a bell for you Marvel fans out there as well. It got its name from a deity of Scandinavian mythology. Heimdall was the god of light in that magical, mythical world. In the year 2000, this name was officially approved by the Astronomical Union. There's another notable crater on Callisto, Adlinda, whose name was also taken from Norse mythology, and it's the third largest of all impact craters. The diameter of Adlinda reaches thousands of kilometers. Like Heimdall, this crater is located in the southern part of the moon. There's another young crater on Adlinda called Laufen. So far, it hasn't been possible to study its properties in more detail. There are ring structures near the Adlinda crater, but they're virtually impossible to see in the images. It's worth paying attention to the Giffel chain, a system 620 kilometers long of craters on Callisto. Such a chain is the longest formation on Jupiter's moon. After some time, the upper layers of Callisto can collapse, whereupon the terrain becomes flat, so low mountain ranges and craters can form in these places. By the way, no tectonic activity has ever been recorded on Callisto. Its state in the solar system has been stable since its formation. The atmospheric layer of Callisto contains carbon dioxide and presumably molecular oxygen, which makes it quite rarefied compared to the Earth's atmosphere. In the ionosphere of the moon, scientists have not recorded high levels of radiation, which means that a person could stay there if they so desired and had a chance to visit. Because of this, and the fact that Callisto has a water layer, it's suggested that this space object could be considered as a potential place for life. This was confirmed by NASA research in 2003. Scientists say that manned space flight to Callisto will be possible in about 20 years. And who knows, perhaps then, even our wildest space-faring fantasies will start to come true. Take a look at the screenshots that are now on the screen. These are statistics from YouTube. What does this mean? Notice, now 57% of viewers of this channel are watching without a subscription. Therefore, in order not to miss Hubble videos, you just need to click on the red button, which looks like this. It's below this video. The law of the universe is simple. Remember that. After all, each of your subscriptions is very important to me. The more viewers, the more often they watch and like, the faster a new mega interesting video will come out.